Hello, my name is Sherman Powell, and I'm a senior family achievement coach. I have the great honor to introduce to you Nas's father, Omiah Gregory. Before I ask Omiah to take the podium, I'd like to have you look at the picture on the screen. Omiah is an amazing father. He and his partner, Raven, are leading the way to their family's continued success. They are wrapping the Nas collaborative around their family by working with several partners, from housing to early childhood to career and finance and family academy classes, including Omiah was a part of the very first and successful Father's Foundation class. The class was awesome, and he showed up to everyone. Omiah is leading the way and getting the support he and his family need. He and Raven are putting their children on a path to college. Please join me in welcoming Omiah Gregory.
Thank you, brother. I appreciate you. Good afternoon. I'm grateful to be here today with you to talk about my experience with Nas. One experience in particular I would like to share. What's up, man? I guess we got somebody. Give a hand for all. One experience I'd like to share is my experience with Father's Foundation. I had the will to change my circumstances, but I didn't know how. The Father's Foundation gave me the tools, the space, and the support I needed to empower myself and make the changes I've always strived for. No more. I come from a rough background where the struggle is real, and that's a hard history I don't want to repeat with my family. I feel like Nas gave me the platform to empower myself and brighten the future of my scholars. Growing up in a single-parent household, we lived check to check. Nobody wants that for their kids. My mother worked two jobs to provide for my siblings. She made miracles. Olivia Ann Gregory is the strongest woman I've ever known. And through her example, I am trying to make the lives of my family better every day. I'm the father of 9 children, which is 5 are with me today, and my fiance, Raven. Nine kids may seem like a lot to handle, and it is. I'm telling you. But it's good having a family that gets together, love each other, and knows each other. That was something I didn't have when I was a kid. I'm blessed to have it now. My family has benefited greatly by partnering with Nas. The first time we had contact with Nas was with our family achievement coach, Sherman. He showed up to our door to talk to Raven about what Nas had to offer. She was in a tough place at that time. We both were. But Sherman didn't give up on us. He set goals with Raven and with the kids. And within a year, things had changed for the better. Raven worked really hard and got a better job, and we finally had childcare we could afford. One of our family goals was to move in a better and safer home, and we did that thanks to Sherman and our partners with PPL. Through this time, Raven was attending family classes through Nas, and I would pick her up and drop her off. I thought it was a program for single moms because I never seen any man. When I became aware that men could go, I jumped at the chance. I saw the change in Raven, and I wanted that change for myself. I attended my first foundations class and was so intrigued by what I was learning and hearing. The classes teach you about nutrition and brain development and how you as a parent need to heal so that your scholars can succeed. Excuse me. After I finished my first foundation class, I wanted more. I didn't do a lot of talking, although I had things I wanted to say, things that men, only black men, could relate to. So I asked the instructor, Vince Frazier, if there was a class just for fathers. The team at Nas was in the process of planning it, and when the Father's Foundation class was announced, I was first in line. I didn't have a father, so I don't know what fatherhood was supposed to look like, though I've always thought it took a special person to be a dad. As men, we're not supposed to talk about our feelings, especially if it shows weakness. The first thing we heard in Father's Foundation was that as fathers, as black fathers, we're hurting. The class was intense with a lot of emotion, and some of the fathers were silent because it's hard to be vulnerable and trust that you can be yourself without judgment. The class started out small, just a few of us, but by the third session, over 10 fathers had joined because the word was out. I wasn't used to being in a place with all black men sharing emotion and it not leading to violence. It was real. One day, 7 or 8 scholars came to the class to teach us techniques about breathing and how to deal with yourself in high stress situations as this. Being taught by the young scholars was exciting, and through them I could see what Naz was doing for the future. I was surprised to see 14 and 15 year old boys talking about the skills that they used to stay positive. Those were skills we was just learning as grown men. Seeing these young men becoming our future leaders was really powerful for all the fathers, and they reminded us and gave us hope for ourselves and our sons. As the weeks went on, I realized that each one of us had the same issues. We was raised in unstable environments, but no matter how instability showed up, we all had issues with our fathers and mothers, and we were all facing obstacles and obstacles between us and being the fathers that we want to be. The class allowed me to acknowledge that I am passionate about my kids, and there's strength and honor in that. It helps me to understand that how I interact with my family today leaves something for them tomorrow, a legacy that I didn't have as a kid. I learned that now I am more powerful than I thought. I learned that I can relate to the struggle of others in a way that I never could before. It's a battle. I fall short of the glory every day, but really it's just we want to be better people. I cherish my family and want to be better for them. Also, I want to be better for myself. 100 years from now, it would not matter what kind of car you drove, what kind of house you lived in, or how much money you had in your bank account, or what your clothes may look like. But the world might just be a little better because you was important enough and lucky enough to change the life of your children. And if you don't have any, change the life of any kid. We must remember that they're our future, and we must guard and protect them and their innocence. Godspeed.
Listen, thank you, Omiah. You are a great man, a great father. You and your family are inspiration to us all. And you know a great father when his son can't leave his side. Say something. He doesn't want to say anything now. We'll give you another opportunity, but he doesn't want to leave his father's side, and my son didn't want to leave my side today, too. He's here, but we want to acknowledge all of the fathers from the Fathers Foundation program. He is not giving up this microphone. I got you. Can we give it up for all of the fathers from our Fathers Foundation program at this table over here? Isn't that wonderful? There are some dedicated fathers that want to see their children successful, and they know what it means to be there every day and to be present. And so we applaud them today.